Beautiful Life Practice Community.
All right. So let's come into a cross-legged shape. Lengthen up through your spine. Soften your shoulders down the back. And do some deep breathing in and out. We're going to explore how it feels to just kind of move through a little bit of a Reiki practice. So take both of your palms and place them in front of your pelvis, like you're cupping in front of your pelvis. Your affirmation here is, I am grounded. Your palms up towards the sacrum. I go with the flow. Your palms up towards your core. The affirmation here is, I am empowered. Take our hands up towards our heart. The affirmation here is, I love unconditionally. Bring your hands up to the third eye. Ooh, I missed one. Bring your hands back down to the throat. Affirmation here is, I am authentic. Now bring your hands up to the third eye, and the affirmation here is, I am intuitive. And bring your hands up to the crown of the head. And the last one is, I am connected. And then you can drop your left arm, just leave your right palm on the skull. And then start to drop your right earlobe down towards your right shoulder. So you're stretching through the side of the neck. You know, Jules's story reminded me of something that happened to me in the fall. Through posting so much on sober Facebook groups, I've connected to a lot of sober people around the world. And there are some people that message me with frequency, some people that I don't know. And there was a guy that was messaging me with frequency, and I was responding to him with frequency. And then at one point it stopped. And then maybe about a month later, his mom contacted me on Facebook to tell me that he had passed away. And my immediate thought when I received that message was like, I could have done more, I should have done more. And then through correspondence with his mom, it was a realization that she was reaching out to me, not to blame me or not to make me regret, but just she thought that I should know because he talked about how inspired he was by me. And it's interesting how you hear something like that and you immediately take it on yourself. You're like, I've done wrong. I haven't helped enough. And Jules's kind of story at the beginning reminded me that, you know, we just need to protect and take care of ourselves and support where we can, but also draw the line where the line is necessary to take care of ourselves first. And just know that by showing up here, that's what you're doing. Lift your head all the way up. And then just feel the difference between one side to the next. Then let's drop the left earlobe. Take the left palm up. Opposite way. How does this side feel compared to the other? Take your head all the way up. And we'll just drop the chin and do some little circles. Then bring the head all the way up through center. And then we're going to stretch into the hips. And we're going to start with lengthening our right leg and then stepping our left leg all the way across. So it's just going to stack, the knee's going to stack. The side of the foot is going to land. And then I'm going to use my cushion on the right side. We're going to take it into a lateral side bend. So we're going to land the right elbow and then lift the left arm over towards the right. I realized when I told that story that I didn't add that when the mom first reached out to me, I immediately assumed that he had passed away because of addiction or mental health. And it ended up being a COVID related death. So it wasn't even what I thought it was. I should add that in. And sometimes our mind catastrophizes things and thinks that things are one way, when in reality, it's not how we perceive it to be. I realize I missed that from the story. So this is a deep stretch for the hip flexor, and it's also a deep stretch for the side of the rib cage, which is a part of the body that I think I notoriously avoid stretching. I don't think about it a lot. The flexibility in the side of our body is really important for kind of opening up our heart and unsticking what's been stuck. Do about 5 more breaths. And we're going to come all the way up. And then we're gonna move into this the opposite way. So lengthening through the left leg. And then the right foot can come to, the right knee can come to bend and then roll onto the outer edge of the right foot. And then if you wanna bring this prop to the other side, and then land your elbow and kind of open your arm to the side, go for it. Stay here for maybe 5 more breaths. Come all the way up and then uncross the leg. The next thing we're going to come into is we're going to do eagle arms, but I'm also going to tuck my toes under and sit on my bottom like this. And if this is too much for your toes, feel free to just skip it. You can also do it for a little bit and then stop. But we're gonna open our arms into cactus arms and then wrap the right arm underneath the left and then high five the hands together or grip opposite shoulders. Nice. So let's stick with it for 2 minutes on this side and 2 minutes on the next. Nice work. Just 1 minute longer. And then lift all the way up. Let's take a little just paddle out of the feet before we do the other side. Coming up to sit when you're ready, opening the arms, and then I believe it should be the left arm underneath the right this time. Almost done. It's getting uncomfortable. It's just probably about 5 more breaths. Lift up, paddle out the feet, and then we're just going to take the knees wide, toes together, and come into a child's pose for a moment. And you can bring your pillow underneath you if you want and just snuggle your body in this little cocoon. Thank you. allowing your body to kind of release anything it's carrying. Give it 5 more breaths. And then you can just gently roll up. Slide that pillow to the side. You're gonna come onto your back body. Roll all the way down. And then hook the strap around your right foot and then just extend through the left leg and try to let this stretch be as passive as possible. So sometimes I see people like really, really trying to pull their leg deeper. See if you can like relax and release and just lightly hold the strap. Start pulling the right leg over to the right. We're going to open up through the inside of the right leg. let's take the right leg up. And then we're gonna pull the right leg over to the left. And you're gonna get a deep stretch through the IT band and also a bit of a twist through the spine. So you're gonna pull your right arm over to the right and gaze over the right shoulder. Right leg all the way up. And let's do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So your left leg is extended, your right leg is extended. Stretching through the back of the left leg. Take your left leg over towards the left. Stretching through the inside of the left leg, the groin. Let's pull the left leg all the way up. And then pull the left leg over to the right. Coming in through that twist. Stretching through the IT band, opening through the left arm. Gazing over the left shoulder. Thank you. something that I have been leading our community a lot through is manifesting lately. And so I invite you, before we head into Shavasana in this last pose, think about what you want to manifest in your life right now. Is it a job? Is it a relationship? Is it something else? See yourself creating that change. Leg all the way back up through center. Let's remove the strap and then bring the knees into the chest. Just give your body a little hug. And then stretch out into your final resting pose, whether you want to take a traditional Shavasana or a butterfly or a seated pose. I think the first step for change and manifestation is to really think about why what you're visualizing is important to you. How is it going to make you feel? I'm going to offer up some affirmations. Is an ever-present loving energy within me, around me, supporting me. Every step of the way. I choose to tune into that energy now. Feeling good attunes me with that energy. It's good to feel good. I trust that everything is working out for me. And in stillness, I receive. Thank you. Just give your fingers and your toes a little wiggle. Running a nice long stretch, fingers all the way through toes. Curl your knees into your chest, give your body a little hug. And then just make your way, when you're ready, up to this seated shape with our hands at our heart center. Closing with the intention. And it's that our practice remains steady and our efforts remain continuous, and that our yoga serves and benefits not just us, but all beings everywhere. May all beings be safe and happy and healthy and free, and may the thoughts and actions of each of our lives contribute towards this. And then let's just finish with an om sound, and we're going to inhale and exhale, and then inhale through to make the om. So take a big breath in. Big breath out. Big breath in. Om. Thank you. Thank you. The light in me sees and it honors the light in you. Namaste.